talking about Anathema. I'm joined by Darren and Danny. So there you go. How are you doing, guys?
Good. That good?
Fine.
Good. Now, how much has the Peaceville Records label contributed to your development as a band thus far, do you feel?
It's definitely had an effect on us, just being on the label Peaceville, because like, the whole attitude of it, like, it's really down to earth, and it's not like some other labels that are totally capitalist labels, just after all the usual stuff. Hammy's like a dead good bloke who's like really honest and that, and that definitely has had an effect on us, being on that label.
He worked with you on the Crestfallen EP and also on some other stuff as well, didn't
he? He'll be working with us in the future as well. He knows what he's doing to get a sound and stuff, and he's more like a drinking partner, really. You know what I mean?
Not too many bands that can say that about their record companies,
we're
is
really
there?
Lucky. That's why we're going to stay with them. You know, grow with the label. You know.
Do you think that the kind of underground feel really suits Anathema?
Yeah, definitely. That's what we're about, like.
Okay. Now, where have you kind of placed yourselves in the death metal genre? And are there any other kind of bands that you feel an affinity with right now?
I don't know. I don't want to place us in any genre, and like, I don't feel that we're. I don't know. There's other bands who obviously like are into playing heavy music and that, and are into emotive stuff. But as for like being generic, I don't think we are.
No, honestly.
Yeah, we're just us. Like, you know, we don't. Every time we write music, we don't think we've got to write this so it's like death metal or doom metal or whatever. We just don't have any limits like that. It's just write what comes out all the time.
Well, we'll talk a little bit about your debut album, Serenades, because Kerrang! Magazine described it as a grieving process put to music. How accurate a description do you feel that is?
Inaccurate.
Quite inaccurate, yeah. There may be parts that are, you know, dealing with the subject of grief, but that's just one topic. You know, we can deal with other things. You can deal with love or no love, anything you want, you know, and Darren writes the lyrics anyway, you'd have to speak to him a bit more about it.
But I mean, but why is it so morose? Why is the style of music you play very, very dark and gloomy? If you're singing about love, then maybe that could be a kind of more brighter sort of music to go with it.
Well, we sing like basically just like about really like deep emotion and that, and strong emotion. We want like, and along with the music, it's all about emotion and expressing emotion in different, many, many different ways. There's so many different emotions. Because like we take our influences from what happens around us, what we see, what we read, what we hear, like the world in general. There's so much like shit in the world, like, to pardon the phrase and that, but you know what I mean? There is a lot of sadness like in the world, and that just comes out probably more in the music.
But those subjects you're talking about are kind of very personal. Why do you feel that you want to express them through music, because you're laying yourselves open for other people to kind of feel your very personal feelings?
Yeah, I suppose so, but it's a good thing, I suppose. I just get out what I feel strongly about, really strongly about, and a lot of things come out, a lot of strange things within like dark recesses of the mind like that I surprise myself sometimes. Like, and when we've been on tour recently, like a lot of people have been coming up and saying, oh, this such and such a song has had a strong effect on me. It's because something might have happened, like, which is similar to their lives, like they can relate to that. And it's sort of like one lad's in Holland said it was therapy to him, just like lyrics and that. So I was really like flattered and that, like,
that must be very rewarding indeed.
Definitely, yeah. That's definitely the best thing. Well, not the best thing, live's the best thing, but that's a good thing.
Okay, was it for Serenades, was it very important to make a statement of intent about Anathema?
Yeah, they were prepared to take any risks, really. And like, we will do so on the next album, and people will hear that. We don't limit ourselves, we just write what comes out, as I said.
There's no main statement with it, though. It's just that we want to, our statement is that probably, but like, as for the album, like, it's just, that's just a name that sums up the music in it. And for the next album, it'll be the same. We'll think up a name that really suits that, and we'll just carry on doing that. Like.
Thank you.
Yeah.